Hi, welcome to Czapek. Welcome to the Geneva Watch Day setup. It's a very unique pandemic-like setup where we all are gathered in small rooms, and here we present a few novelties. Quite a few, in fact, because we started to shoot in July with a new chronograph, Faubourg de Cracovie, California Dreamin, a Californian dial, as you can imagine, with a little tribute to the authors of California Dreamin, the music. Then we move on to, 2 days ago, launching the Tourbillon Place Vendôme Dark Matter. So as its name expresses, it's all about darkness. So black ADLC case, we'll see in detail, a black enamel dial that you already have seen. And then honeycomb kind of bridges finish that are very unique. My favorite Place Vendôme so far. The last one is certainly the most important one because it's the continuation of the story Antarctique. It's called Abyss. It's a blue varnish with an ethereal shape. And you can see that it's all handmade, yet you don't really understand how it is handmade. And this is part of the fascination that this model is creating. It's only 10 pieces to keep you excited for the last revelation that will come just before Christmas, the next model of Antarctique. The Dark Matter is the wildest of all the Place Vendôme we have made, and possibly the nicest. Only for the story, it's already a fantastic one, because it was born out of a bespoke order made by two friends for four orders of their sons. So it was a collection of six tourbillons in six different colors, orange, purple, green, blue, and sitting with them, I told them, come on, let's do a seventh one, but this one is for us, all black, and that's how the Dark Matter, so made of old shades of black, was born. Black ADLC case, black bridges with an honeycomb design in it, polished, black enamel, what else can you dream of? The Antarctic collection starts with meeting so many of you guys, with meeting watch collectors worldwide in all these events that were popping up before the pandemic, and where we were talking about the beauty of watchmaking, the excitement we have when we look at a beautiful movement. So we wanted to make our own first in-house movement. What does that mean? We wanted to start from a white sheet of paper, and we wanted to design a super powerful engine, something that could become possibly the most powerful micro rotor ever made. Why micro rotor? Because we wanted to reveal all the gear train, all the different components of the movement without having a rotor over it, hiding part of it. And the last part, I would say, that we're searching for a kind of aesthetic, something that maybe I could call horological erotism, where you can reveal a bit, but not all of it. Creating a movement like this means every component offers a variety of potential failures. So that's the reason why so few people create a base movement. Working on the debugging, we've been confronted with a winding power that was not as high as we wanted it. So we have introduced some changes to the movement. And the movement will not anymore be 100% recycled gold, but 100% recycled platinum micro rotor. So that's one of the first changes. We have also reworked on the anglage, on the six inward angles, on different aspects of aesthetics. And so we are giving a little bit of a heads up on what will be looking like the new movement, which will be released in October. So it's a race, and we're going to make it for this fall. The last element, for sure, is to speak again about the watch collectors, because the support, the feedback we got were incredible. So we are in a very strange economic situation where, in fact, we've been receiving more orders than we have never ever received. And at the same time, we're working in a very complex moment where half of the partners are closed or working part-time, and it's very difficult to make things happen. You need twice more work for the same output. So yeah, 2020 will be in our minds as a very strange year, but not necessarily for the same reasons as the one people could expect.